Recently, I released a video where I showed you what a tesseract is and one method our puny three-dimensional brains can use to try to understand a four-dimensional object. So if you haven't seen that video, I recommend you go check that out first. Welcome to On the Shoulders of Science. I'm Ben, and if this is your first time here and you want to learn about cool and interesting scientific facts and concepts in a fun and easy to understand way, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. Okay, so a tesseract is essentially a four-dimensional cube. Last video, I showed you one method to visualize a tesseract using a Schlegel diagram, but this time, we're going to do things a little differently. Okay, so first consider a two-dimensional world, just an x and y axis. Now let's take a three-dimensional shape and move it through this two-dimensional world. Now if you were a little two-dimensional being, doing this would look like a square appeared and then suddenly disappeared. Essentially, you're seeing individual slices of a three-dimensional shape over the course of time. So you can use this information to reconstruct what the original shape looks like. Now, if you did this with a sphere, you would see a tiny circle grow into a larger circle and then shrink and disappear again. And keep in mind, you can also project the shapes in other orientations too. For example, if you shoot this cube edge first, a two-dimensional creature would see a rectangle pop into existence, grow, and then shrink and pop out of existence again. Okay, now let's move this up a dimension. Now we'll take a four-dimensional shape and move it through a three-dimensional world. This time we're on the other end of the deal. We're watching a four-dimensional shape move through our world. So this is what it would look like if we moved a slightly rotated tesseract through our 3D world. That's pretty cool. Each frame we see here is a three-dimensional slice of a tesseract. Just like how a three-dimensional object has two-dimensional slices, a four-dimensional object has three-dimensional slices. A three-dimensional slice. That's kind of weird to think about, but that's how 4D shapes work. In a similar vein, if you took a four-dimensional sphere and moved it through our three-dimensional world, it would look like a sphere appeared, got bigger, smaller, and then disappeared. But if you ask me, I like watching the rotated tesseract move through our 3D world more. And if you like this video, make sure to subscribe if you haven't already. And if you like learning about four-dimensional shapes, you might also like my video on the beginner's guide to solving a Rubik's Cube. Link in the description. Thank you everyone for watching. I hope you learned something, and I'll see you next time.